It's been almost 4 years since the last time I've been to Vietnam. COVID made it impossible to see my family and explore the country. This month, I was blessed with the opportunity to redeem the last 4 years.
What's up, buddy?
I didn't know you were gonna be here. I'm quite home.
One of the main reasons I went to Vietnam was to attend a Trinh family reunion on my dad's side of the family. My family has been doing this reunion for many centuries, and this is going to be my first time attending. I got to see and experience the culture and traditions that my ancestors left behind. I got to meet family members that I've never met before and try foods that I've never tried before. Here's this video of me eating lamb blood. Haiphong is a city located in northern Vietnam and is the third largest city in Vietnam with a population of over 2 million people. This was my first time going to Haiphong and I didn't know much about the city. I visited the statue of Lý Chánh, a female general who rose against Chinese rule in 40 AD and ruled Haiphong until her defeat in 43 AD. I crossed one of their many bridges, ate some good food, and met this cute puppy. Hanoi is the capital and second largest city of Vietnam. It's also known for having a great nightlife. Besides having amazing nightclubs, Hanoi is also home to many historic landmarks. I got to visit Quốc Tử Giám, also known as the Temple of Literature. Quốc Tử Giám is a historical education institution of Vietnam. Students who graduate were also considered to be amongst the most learned and respected members of Vietnamese society. Hue was one of the places where I got to see a lot of landmarks, eat a lot of good food, and learn a lot about Vietnamese history. Oh, I also encountered a wild venomous snake. Besides the snake, other exciting parts of Hue were exploring this abandoned house, visiting the tomb of Khai Tinh, and I got a ride from the bicycle man. The last destination for my trip is the city that never sleeps. I've been to Saigon many times in the past. It's my favorite place to visit, not because of the city, but because of my family. My aunt was my main tour guide for my time in Saigon. She showed me what Vietnam had to offer for someone my age. All the cafes, food spots, and areas that are popular to the youth. Saigon has so much to offer, but my aunt wanted to take me to this little town in the countryside. My aunt took me to her boyfriend's hometown in Hang Nu. This was my first time visiting, and prior to this visit, I didn't even know this town existed. I got to visit this garden, home to this cat and baby birds, play tennis with the elderly, eat amazing food of course, and meet many animals. On my last day there, Tom's dad made this amazing pork dish for me before I left. And he told me that he made this dish for me, so next time I come to Vietnam, I'll have a reason to come visit again. Due to COVID, I couldn't visit my family for the last 4 years, and within those last 4 years, I lost my great aunt and my grandma. My time in Saigon was a reminder to myself to appreciate the people that are a part of my life, whether it's a family member, friend, significant other, stranger, old friend, relative you've never met. Every single moment spent with them gives time more value than just being a continuous sequence of existence.